Okay, let's go. Thomas Jefferson was born in Virginia on April 13, 1743. So raise your hands up in the air as you follow me. He grew up on a farm in a wealthy family and had six sisters. His brothers were three. And if you do the math well, then that's 10 kids. His mom and his dad should get a medal for this. Thomas Jefferson was 57 years of age when he was inaugurated on the presidential stage. He was only the third American president. He knew the stakes were high, so he set the precedent. During his term of the presidency, he worked persistently in an effort to keep the United States out of war with the French. Napoleonic Wars, yeah, the times were tense. But we were in good hands with Mr. Thomas Jefferson. He was a skilled writer, and not only that, he could speak five languages fluently. He handled the presidency effortlessly. He also wrote the draft of the Declaration of Independence. He really rose above. 75% of what he wrote remain as the final declaration. That's off the chain. See what I'm saying? Thomas Jefferson was insane with his brain, and he fought with his pen. He even got the French to sell Louisiana back in 1803. That's bananas. And he designed his own home too. It was a large mansion named Monticello. It was built on a hill in Charlottesville, Virginia. And that home is still there. He was the first president to introduce the custom of shaking hands to greet his guests. Before that, everybody just bowed. This was hard to do, especially in a crowd, I guess. Thomas Jefferson's portrait has been printed on a $2 bill ever since 1862. And now you know, so the next time you see one, I told you so. He married Martha Wayne Skeleton, yeah, that's her name, back in 1772. It's a shame. They had six children, only two survived to adulthood. And even Martha died. A sculpture of Thomas Jefferson's head is up on Mount Rushmore. And if you measure it, you see that it's 60 feet high of granite. The thing is so big that they could hardly make it fit. The University of Virginia was founded by Mr. Thomas Jefferson, the third president, back in 1819. And they considered it to be one of TJ's greatest achievements. And he died on the same day and within a few hours. And second president, John Adams, the two powers, both passed away on July 4th of 1826. Now going forward.